Hello everyone, I am Sanjay Chauhan, Assistant Professor in Electrical Engineering Department, IET, Dr. Rammanohar, Lohia, Avadh University, Faizabad. So friends, in this video lecture series, we will study the subject Basic Electrical Engineering. Some part of this subject we have already studied in our classroom learning, so we will continue right from where we were in the classroom. So, the topic for today's lecture is single phase AC series and parallel circuits. One more thing before starting, that each lecture will follow an assignment and you will have to complete that assignment on paper, and then after taking the snap or scanning it, you will have to mail me back that assignment. Then and after that, whenever you will come to the college, you will have to submit in hard form. Then only the assignment will be completed. And also the transcript of this video lecture will be provided along with the video file, so that wherever the audio is not clear, you can go to the transcript and make it clear. So let us start with today's topic. So if we have a single phase AC circuit which contains a voltage source V and only a pure resistance like this, so circuit current will flow across the resistor and we can draw the waveform. Or before drawing the waveform, we can write the characteristic equation. We know from Ohm's law that V will be equal to I into R. So if we know the voltage, if voltage is given as V is equal to Vm sine omega t, then from this equation we can find out the I. I will be equal to V by R. So after putting this V from here, we will get I as I is equal to Im sine omega t, where this Im is equal to Vm by R, which is also called the peak value of the current. So we can see from the instantaneous value of this V, which is equal to Vm sine omega t, and I, which is equal to Im sine omega t, that there is no phase difference between these two quantities. So now we, using these two equations, we can draw the waveform for these two signals, means for voltage and current, t time or phase angle alpha. So if this is the voltage waveform, then we can say that current waveform can be drawn like this. This is V and this is I. So there is no phase difference between these two waveforms, which can also be drawn in phasor diagram like this. If this is the voltage phasor, then this is our current phasor. No phase difference between voltage and current. So this phasor V for pure resistive circuit can be written as its magnitude and phase angle 0 degree. Similarly, current phasor I can be written with its magnitude and phase angle, which is also 0 degree. In rectangular form, we can write it as V cos 0, which will be 1, plus j 0, means there will be only real part in this phasor. And similarly for current, there will be only a real part. So these are voltage and current phasors
for a pure resistive circuit.
So if we find total resistance offered by the circuit for the flow of the current, then it will be R, which can be written in phasor form like this. Phasor V divided by phasor I. So from here, in rectangular form, V can be written as V plus J 0. That is only real part, no imaginary part. Similarly, current can be written with its magnitude as real part and no imaginary part. So these magnitudes V and I are actually the RMS values of voltage and current. We all know this. So it will be V by I. So R is equal to V by I, and the unit is ohm. So this is the total resistance offered by the circuit, purely resistive circuit, for the flow of the current. So as we studied purely resistive circuit, similarly we can move forward with purely inductive circuit. So a purely inductive circuit, a single phase AC circuit, will contain a source and an inductor. Voltage is V, circuit current is I, and inductance is L. So we know that induced EMF across the inductor will be equal and opposite to the applied voltage. So if V is given as Vm sine omega t, then we can find out the current, circuit current, by using the characteristic equation of this inductor. That is, V will be equal to L di by dt. From this equation we can find out the I, because di will be equal to 1 upon L V into dt. And after integration we will get I as Vm upon omega L sine omega t minus pi by 2. It means current lags the voltage by an angle pi by 2. So we can draw the waveform. In this waveform, voltage is shown here and current is shown here. So current lags voltage by an angle pi by 2. So we can draw the phasor diagram also. If this is our voltage phasor, then current phasor will lie 90 degree lagging to voltage. So this is the phasor diagram for purely inductive circuit. Now if we write the phasors V and I, then phasor V will be in phasor form, it can be written as V, its magnitude, and phase angle 0 degree. And with respect to this V, if we write the current phasor, then current phasor will be its magnitude and phase angle minus 90 degree. Okay, it means in rectangular form we can write the voltage phasor as V plus J 0, means only real part, no imaginary part, while current can be written as 0 minus J into I. It means the real part of the current phasor will be 0, while it will have imaginary part. So Using these phasor expressions, we can find out the total resistance offered by this circuit for the flow of the current. So we know that the ratio V by I in phasor form will be the total resistance offered for the flow of current by this circuit. So if we calculate this in phasor form, then V will be V, whereas I will be minus J into I. Or we can write this in polar form. It will be V, phase angle 0, and divided by I, phase angle minus 90 degree. It means we will get the resistance V by I as magnitude and phase angle 90 degree. So this is the resistance which is called Z, means impedance of the circuit. And this quantity Vm upon omega L can be written as Im. So Im means peak value of the current for this circuit will be equal to Vm upon omega L. So in this way, in a pure inductive circuit, current lags voltage by an angle 90 degree. And the total resistance offered by the circuit for the flow of current is Z, which is equal to V by I and phase angle 90 degree. So this is called impedance of the circuit. Impedance. And further, this impedance can be written in rectangular form as V means RMS value. So it will be Vm by root 2. And the magnitude of I will be this Im divided by root 2. So from here we can take Im. Im will be Vm upon omega L. And further we will divide it by root 2 to get RMS value of the current. And phase angle 90 degree. So it will become omega L and phase angle 90 degree. Means in rectangular form, this Z can be written as 0 plus J omega L, where this omega L is called XL, which is inductive reactance of the circuit. So in this way, we can also study purely capacitive circuit, which will contain a source and a pure capacitor. Once again, the voltage is V and circuit current is I. V is given as Vm sine omega t. And we know the characteristic equation of a capacitor, which is equal to, means I is equal to C, that is capacitance of the capacitor, into dV by dt. So from here we can find out the current after putting this V. So it will become C times Vm d sine omega t with respect to differentiation with respect to time. So upon differentiation we will get the final result as Vm upon 1 upon omega c into sine omega t plus pi by 2. This is I. It means this I, instantaneous value of the I, can be written as Im sine omega t plus pi by 2. So this is I and this is V. So we can clearly see that there is a phase difference of pi by 2 between voltage and current in a purely capacitive circuit. And also the current leads voltage by 90 degree. And this Im is equal to Vm upon 1 upon omega c. So using these two equations, we can draw the waveform for voltage and current. So if this is the voltage waveform V, then current will lead by 90 degree. It means this is our current waveform. There is a phase difference of pi by 2. Current leads voltage by pi by 2. And we can also draw the phasor diagram. If this is our voltage phasor, then current phasor will lead voltage phasor by 90 degree. So in phasor form, we can write V as its magnitude plus J into 0, means only real part, and I as its magnitude into cos 90, which will be 0, means even real part will be 0, and there will be imaginary part as J into I. So using this, we can find out the total resistance offered by this circuit for the flow of the current. So total resistance, that is, which is called impedance, will be equal to phasor V divided by phasor I. So it will be V, in polar form we can write as V0 and I 90 degree, plus 90. So it will be V0 divided by I 90 degree, and it will become V by I minus 90 degree. So further we can write V and I. So Z will become V by I minus 90 degree. So by putting this V from this equation, we will get Vm by root 2, and I from here we will get Vm into omega c divided by root 2, and phase angle minus 90 degrees. So it will become omega 1 upon omega c and phase angle minus 90 degree. So in rectangular form it can be written as it's 0 plus it will become minus J into 1 upon omega c, because cos sine minus 90 degree will be minus 1 in ohms. So this is the impedance of the circuit. And this 1 upon omega c is called the capacitive reactance of the circuit, as it contains only a pure capacitor denoted by XC.